Hello everyone, this is Anita Kejriwal from Dress My Craft. Today I have a wonderful gift box for you, that is this four-tiered gift box made with the Vintage Saga paper collection, a new paper collection by Dress My Craft. This box is so beautiful and easy to make and can hold an assortment of gifts which will really bring a smile on your loved one's face. So let's begin. First, I have a craft cardstock that is 12 inches by 6 1/4 inch. This is a sturdy cardstock and I am using my Dress My Craft scoring board to make the score lines at 3 inches, 6 inches and 9 inches. So the score lines are at 3 inches, 6 inches and 9 inches. Now using my Argo bone folder, I am scoring the across the score lines, the folding across the score lines, burnishing it well. And this Argo bone folder gives me crisp and clear folds without leaving any crease marks on the paper. To make the four boxes, I need four pieces of square-sized cardstock from the craft paper, that is at 5/7 inch and 5/7 inch. And I'll make score lines at 1.5 inches on all sides. So again, I'm using the Dress My Craft scoring board to make score lines at 1.5 inches on all the four paper sizes, that is 5/7 by 5/7. Now I will make a slit here. I'm giving a slit like so, as you see here on the paper, and I'll be doing that for all the four card papers which I'll be using to make the boxes. Make the slits like this and make a small slit, like a triangle portion is cut off from the sides of this square on the top, which makes folding very easy. So be careful that you do not cut across the scoring line, and I'm using my precision scissor to give the cuts. So this you will do for all the four boxes. Now I've applied tacky tape on the flaps and I am folding the flaps like this to make the box. Be careful not to make the folds across the score lines. Your folds should align with the score lines to make perfect boxes. You can use tacky glue or any other glue which you find comfortable, but the boxes should be made in a very sturdy manner so that they do not open up. So here my four boxes are ready, and now I will be using the vintage photo distress ink to distress the edges. This will give a real vintage look to my project. You can use walnut stain or any other brown ink color which you have. I'll be also applying distress ink on all the straight edges of the big paper fold which I had done earlier. Now what I did was I added a tacky tape at the back of the box, that is the main box, that is the folder, and then I've used a shabby crumpled ribbon, maroon color satin ribbon, across it so that I can use to tie it when I want to fold the box. I'm using this Vintage Saga paper collection. This is a wonderful paper collection for all those who love vintage theme papers. You have to look at the designs to see how wonderful they are. Each design is unique in its own. The paper is sturdy 240 GSM, and these wonderful designs really are so beautiful. One doesn't have the heart to cut them. So I'm using this paper pad today, the papers from this collection, to make my box. I am really at no loss of words as to decide which ones to select, because each the paper is so beautiful. As you see, they have real shabby chic, old vintage charm, and it's a wonderful paper collection, and you all must have it in your stash. So let me see which one I choose from. Let me see. So I'll be using this design to make the inside of my box, because it has some muted design and doesn't have much motifs on top, and I'll be using this paper as well. So these are the two sheets which I have chosen for my folder. Now I'll be needing this to cover the folder, that is the craft folder which I have on my scoreboard, and for this I have cut paper size according to the 3-4 panels which I have. You have to measure the paper sizes using the ruler, and then using the tacky glue, I'm just applying these card panels on the inside of the folder. As you notice, there's a small cut at the last folder, but doesn't matter because that will get covered with the box. This is the outside of the folder, and I've used this beautiful rose design on top and the musical sheet on top to cover. And then using the Algo Bold folder, I am removing any creases or air bubbles which have been trapped here. Now let me align the boxes and see whether I have done a perfect work or not. I think they look perfect, don't you think so? So now what we have to do is to cover the boxes as well with the vintage sheets of paper. And for that, I am using the scraps of whatever has been left behind. So let me see. I'll finish covering with this scrap paper, all these boxes, the inside and the outside. Every bit of it has to be covered. I'll also be using some of this paper, the design, this black design, to give a beautiful look to my boxes. So this is how they look. The black acts as a contrast against the brown background and looks really wonderful. Now let's start sticking the boxes. For this, first you have to stick the topmost box using the tacky glue tape. I am sticking the topmost box, and then you begin by sticking the bottommost box. So in this is done so that you get the perfect alignment for the two boxes in the middle. So I am now applying tacky tape like so, and then I will be fixing it with the bottom. Now you see that that small slit which we had at the bottom flap as by now covered with the box, and now you have the perfect alignment for the other two boxes. So no need of measuring with the ruler or marking or anything. This way you will get a perfect aligned boxes, and you will see that when I close the box, you get close the box so easily without the boxes really interfering with each other. I'll be using the ribbon to tie the box and see whether it closes perfectly or not. I think it looks perfect, don't you think so? Now I will need a lid for my box. So to measure the lid, I have taken a paper that is 5 1/8 by 5 1/8 inch, and then like I had done for the boxes earlier, in the same manner you have to create the lid. So using my Argo Bold folder, I am again burnishing against my score lines, and always remember to burnish against the bumpy side, that is against the side that is has the bump, and the opposite side, that is dent, you have to make the burnishing. Now I have also added some distressing on the edges and covered with the paper as I had done for the boxes. So here my boxes are ready, my folder is ready with the box. Now I need to do some decoration, and then I'll show you the complete box once it is over. You can add tags, little gift cards or whatever to your vintage box using the motif sheets, paper cutouts, die cuts, flowers. It's all up to you how you want to decorate this. So I'll be showing you the finished work as soon as I do the decoration. This is my box that is complete, and I hope you like it. Do make this box and share with us. You can visit dressmycraft.com for all your craft supplies. Thanks for